So today I'm gonna be showing you how to make a Twitch overlay and graphics pack. The free PSDs will be down in the description, so if you want to download those, go ahead to MediaFire and download those. This is like my first take on a Twitch stream overlay in a long time, so usually I like to go on here and figure out what kind of games they're playing. So if they're playing, say, Fortnite gameplay, download one of these. Nice 1920 by 1080 or 720 image, either one works. Go ahead and download that. Drag it in. And then I like to do a field blur on it. It's really just to get the feel of what the graphics might look like on a picture like that, or image. Okay, next, let's go ahead and grab a webcam video PNG. Webcam video. It's probably not what you want to look on there. Go ahead and grab a 1081. These are all weird. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead. we're gonna just create one on here. So I know I have some pictures on here that are 1080. Like. This one right here should be, yeah, so we're gonna go ahead and pretend this is a webcam. Go ahead and drag it down here. This guy wants orange and blue, so we're gonna go ahead and put the webcam right there. Create the rectangle around it for the outline. Drag it underneath that layer. And then add a gradient to it, so he wants orange and blue. I think it's gonna look weird together, so I'll probably just go with the orange right now. Yeah, it kinda has a purple offset, so let's go ahead and do this. Line it up a little better. Looks a little thick. Shrink it down. Gradient. That's a good one right there. Okay, that's cool. Let's go ahead and frame that and call it. So hold on. If I can click on it, call webcam overlay. Okay. Now you need some things underneath there to say, okay, new subscriber, you know, new donation, whatever it may be. So let's go ahead and match those up perfectly. A little thick on there. Let's go ahead and do a gradient overlay. And we will do... add a square to the end, make it same height. I don't know the shortcut for this control, so I'm just gonna wing it for a second. We're gonna go ahead and do a warp. Let's zoom in, make sure it lines up with the layer, right? Maybe a little more. Perfect. Let's see if we can't mess around with that a little bit. Perfect. Okay, there's one. We can go ahead and duplicate this. We might want to shrink it down. It looks a little tall to me, so that's actually okay. Yeah, let's shrink it down from the top. Yeah, it looks good. So we got one. Two. And let's add the third. Okay, so we got those. Probably should have grouped these together before, so let's go ahead and do that. Go 01, we'll call it really 1. Call this one 02. Super important to label this stuff, because if you get ahead of yourself and you don't have a label, that kind of sucks. You gotta go back and it takes forever to labeling over. Okay, so 03. Okay. Go ahead and turn these two off for a second. Again, I don't usually do stream graphics. We're gonna go ahead and take a look at what people use these for. If they're doing things under the webcam, it is new donation, new follower. Okay. Go ahead and do new. Donation. little uniform so the text matches up. Kind of like a slanted text, looks good with this what color combination right there. Donation. Drag that down. Let's mess around with the spacing, this lettering for a second. Yeah, not the best. Let's go ahead and do this. And we'll add a little line right here. We'll make this a little bit transparent. But no, let's keep it like that. We're gonna grab our eraser tool. We're going to erase some of this. Keep that down to 6%. There you go. You got a cool line for that. It's been kind of weird. Let's go ahead and back to the layer itself. Let's rasterize it for the smart object so I can move it better. We're gonna drag it up just a little bit. Center it. Cool, so you get the donation, the text can go right there and it'll scroll across. I don't know exactly what I'm going to do with that yet, but we're going to copy this, put it onto our O1 layer, duplicate the text, put it on the O2 so we can go ahead and mess around with that now, and let's drag that down. New donation. What's the subscriber? Okay. Little bit big, doesn't exactly match up, but we'll go ahead and fix that with instead of shrinking it, we're gonna keep it the same size. We're just gonna do that. A little bit more, a couple more pixels. There we go. Style stays the same. Doesn't really affect anything too much. And let's go ahead and duplicate that one more time. Drag that up to here. And what is the other one people use? It is subscriber, donation, follower. So again, that is the warp text because I messed with it in that layer. So if it doesn't, we go ahead and drag that back out a little bit. Hold shift while you're doing it, it makes it go a little faster, I think. Jumps pixels instead of going one by one. Okay, so we got 03, 02, 01 done. What other kind of stuff people use? And again, you can move these around whatever you want. People use things at the top. You can go ahead and add that. Let's add a little, switch buttons, overlay. Look at some more examples. Okay, so they have the whole username, Instagram kind of deal. Let's go ahead and do something like that. Rectangle up here. Make it our gradient. Looks like they have a layer on top of this, so let's go ahead. Duplicate that. Turn the gradient off. Make that one. Color match the gray. It down a little bit. Okay. Now we got something to work with. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm actually going to match this to the middle of this layer pretty much. Like right about there. Grab my control key on the keyboard and shift. And then kind of extend it out. Then hit edit. The horizontal. See where I'm going with this. Look better in a minute. Okay, and these two do not match up perfectly, so we're gonna go ahead and drag this down. And we will copy these two layers again. definitely hate how this looks. That happens quite often when you're designing, so let's go ahead and take that off. Make this the gradient. It's the layer behind. Okay. Let's figure out how we're gonna do this, make this look better. Let's take the color off it. Already has the gradient. Shrink this rectangle down. Drag this one up. A little bit better, not perfect. Use some more like flare to this thing. Okay, so we'll do that. We'll go 40.8 degrees. Alright, there it is. That looks a little better. Go ahead and add some text so we can fill it out. What do they got on here? Username. Okay, so, it's Dominic. Let's go ahead and text Dominic. This italicized might not look up here, so let's go ahead and see what we can do with that. Yeah, we'll add some flair to that too. It doesn't look very good. Go ahead, changes. We're done. Square that up. Put these layers up. Perfect. Okay. Make this look a little more intense. We're gonna go ahead and add the black and white filter to the background. Just helps us see how things might look. Okay, that looks better. Dominic. He needs Instagram logo, so let's go ahead and grab one of those. I want to keep the style the same, so let's go ahead and do white. Let's go to Twitter logo. And these will work because they're change the color of them eventually anyway. That's not the one we want. It's a color really, let's make that white too. It's the top. And I think it's Instagram. This example, you can only change the text. Alright, let's go ahead and drag that over. Okay. Okay, so we got this layer over here. Let's go ahead and drag our Twitter file into there. Not good for now. Make sure it's the same size. Yep, not even. Color overlay. Make it white. Take a look at some blur before doing. Okay. Okay. Alright. Definitely time to group these up so we do not lose our place. And Twitter logo has got to go over a little more. And again, I don't like the way this looks, so we're going to go ahead and do that. We can add a gradient. Go ahead and create our own gradient. We're gonna do a silver, so it's gonna go from white to gray. Let's make sure we can. Not the best. Let's go ahead and make this Keep it white for now. We'll change it in a little bit. Can I figure this out? All right, let's go ahead and make. Effects to add onto here. Not straight. Let's go ahead. If you hold down shift while you do this, it'll always become perfectly straight. A little more. Alt and keyboard. You gotta drag this over to the bottom with one pixel missing. You gotta drag it over one so it becomes equal. Makes this one longer, makes that one longer. And we got those. We're gonna go ahead and make a cool effect right here. So we're gonna duplicate that layers and drag it up here. A little closer than I'd like. Let's go ahead. Over. Yeah, X is too big. Let's change that first. Perfect, so we're gonna go ahead and duplicate that. Another one to the top. And same with over here. Make sure they're perfectly even. Right there, okay. Cool. Looks better. Better. We're going to go ahead and group text together with all of these. So let's go ahead and grab that dominant text. Let's grab these together. Group them. All that top text. And shrink that down a little bit more. Okay. That's even. Sometimes it won't let me be. Should add the layer guides, but. Like them, so it's even. Let's go ahead and add drag this over. Did not do one for the Instagram, so let's go ahead and do that. Let's label these two Instagram and Twitter. Instagram, drag it over. I'm not gonna copy these guys, I just wanna get some perspective because I've never done stream graphics. Well, I've done them, but just not a long time. So yeah, this gray, yeah, I agree. This gray can use a little bit of a gradient on there, or let's try one more, let's try a bevel first. Just like that, okay, that's perfect. Let's put a flare to it. Dominic text is still off. Let's go ahead and realign that. Sorry if this is taking so long, guys. It's just my first time doing this in a long time. Stream stuff. Okay, these might look a little plain. Let's go ahead and try something. Nah, looks better white. Okay. Alright, well, we got that done. Is there anything else that goes on the actual stream? Go ahead and group it all together. Call that good for a second. And we'll call that stream overlay. Always save your work sometimes here because you never know what's going to happen. Overlay. So now we know the colors. We're going to go ahead and do a stream offline screen. Good. Great, great and overlay because we like that one obviously. And the text offline. We'll check out the guys got a stream schedule, so we're gonna go ahead and advertise that. Shrink that down. And offset that, we'll make this text a little bit. That kind of cool bevel emboss we did earlier. Change that. Just a little bit of top. Okay. Looks good. Now we need some cooler effects on here because this looks pretty lame. Go ahead and bring this rectangle over, even it out. Even it out. I'll show you why in a second. So let's go ahead. So when I warp it, I don't mess it up when I duplicate it to this side. Match the style of all the icons and the top donos and things like that. We got going. Looks good. Drag that over. And then we're going to duplicate this again. Drag it under. And we're going to change the opacity down to 48. Pretty good. Okay. We're going to scale this up actually a little bit. We're going to rotate it. There we go. Looks good. Duplicate it, edit, transform, flip horizontal. Just gonna drag it to their side. If you want, you can do this where you flip it vertically, different offset. Yeah, that looks cool. Okay, I group that together. I'm gonna call it R1 for right side. I'm gonna call this L2 for left side. Yeah, I did not group those. Okay, it's alright, it still doesn't have enough flare to go ahead and see what we got in the downloads folder. Maybe like stepping our boots or anything, let's see. Nope, so we'll create a new layer. We will grab our paintbrush tool. Have this kind of splatter effect where it does random stuff like this. Sometimes you gotta undo every once in a while. Better. Let's go ahead and drag that under to the L1, L2. If I change the color burn, does it do anything? Yeah, so it's red. We don't want that. Let's go ahead and hit the light. I'm just gonna mess around with these, even the fill sometimes. Sometimes at a certain point, the fill look really good. That looks better. What if we did this? What if we grab that one, convert to smart object, rasterize it, and layer via cut this one, change it to white. Looks better. This one's a little bit in the way down here too, so let's go ahead and grab this. Already rasterize it, so we don't gotta worry about that. Up the paintbrush size, make sure our opacity is low, hardness. Gonna erase it on there a little bit. Offline is a little bit too in your face. That here in a second. So first we're going to work smart object. Oops, wrong layer. We're going to get the offline text, we're going to convert to smart object, we're going to rasterize it. Now we're going to do some cuts on there. We're going to go ahead and do this. Layer via cut. This offline part we can go up there like that. It looks cool. Footer schedule, it looks okay. That bevel embossment is a little too much. Let's go ahead and I just searched grunge rectangle for this effect, but it looks really cool. If I have it in this computer, check. Yep, right there as I mess it all up. Okay, that looks cool. So we're gonna go ahead and drag this under all of our text. I'll warp it a little bit. Now that looks off a little bit, right? So we're going to this, widen it. The text, this happens all the time where you think you got something cool, you gotta change the text color. Or something different, which is fine. Much on there. That looks cool. Offline, like I said, it's a little bit too. Little too much. We're gonna turn that off for both layers. Group them back together. And add a drop shadow. Looks better. Still a little plain though, so what can we do now? Make this look cool. I don't know what we can do. Let's go to. I have a master file on here. And I will be turning this into some packs that you guys can download on Mediafire. Just have to get around to it. I have one coming out at 500 subs, so that should be out here in a couple days. Let's open up. I'll speed do this part. Okay, we got this pack open. This is my effects pack. I've kind of had a conglomerate of a lot of stuff over the time. Some of the stuff might not work, but we're gonna try it anyway. So we're gonna go into overlays, grab this line overlay, and drag it onto here. Again, this pack will be available for download on PSD, right into the overlay. So that has a soft light effect on there. Let's go normal. Rig under everything. Go try hard light. Soft light again. Kind of looks cool with everything, honestly. Yeah, that's pretty cool. I like that. So we're gonna stick with that. Call that good for that layer. Or this offline screen. Call it offline screen. Okay, we got that. Now, what else do we need? We need little buttons. Okay. Let's go ahead and make this darker. Well, it's gonna be a white background on Twitch, so let's go ahead and cover overlay that white. And I know these can be any size. I've done them in the past for my other company. Yes. Go ahead and do a color overlay on these. Life. Gradient overlay. Change those to that. And a little on top, so it looks cool. Alright, let's see. Oh, let's hide that on there. That white looks good with the background. Okay. On this one now, we will add a little bit of something to match that. So we'll add kind of effect we added on. Our overlay earlier. Go ahead and edit. Warp. Hold down shift. If you hold down shift, it just makes it go a little quicker sometimes. Depends. But we're having an issue here where this isn't lining up exactly right. So it kind of fades off. Starts off strong, fades off, and it doesn't look good on the bottom of it. Let's see. So we're going to go to our main rectangle. We're going to convert that to a smart object. Drag this rectangle, drag it down there, and create a clipping mask. But now wherever you drag it, so you can drag it anywhere, it will not go off that rectangle. Looks a lot better that way. We're gonna grab the about me text, drag it over. That looks alright, this looks a little bit too off though, so let's go ahead and drag this back over. Rectangle. That looks better. Okay, I actually like that. about me. Now we got a cool spot for, like, go to a person icon PNG. A lot of these are starter stocks, so I can't get them. But, you know what? Let's get a picture of him. Might be blurry if I download off of here, but we'll try it anyway. And we will, see if we can drag this. We're gonna try something weird here for a second. Give me just a second to try it. Put that on there. We're gonna drag him in the cookie mask, just what it looks like. Yeah, I like that. I'm gonna shrink these two down. This layer needs to go out a little more. Enough room for it. Alright, oh, let's turn off it. On me. Happy with that one. So we're gonna go ahead and group this entire thing together and call that about me. Got one. Got two. What's the next one? Social media. Okay. I just call it social. No longer need this whole doohickey, so we'll get rid of that. And let's get a. Is there like a generic social media logo? Just type in generic. Because I'm not going to be able to fit a lot on there. A little tricky. Let's go ahead and add that, because that's universal. That's on Twitter now and Facebook. That white so it matches everything else. Color with white. It's definitely not centered. Okay, cool. So now we got copy. Let's add that in there. Call that one social. Everyone likes to add up PC specs. I don't know if you guys can hear anything above me, but there's someone upstairs just going crazy. PC icon PNG. Type in transparent PNG either one. I like the tower part maybe, because that looks better. Tower. Yeah, something like that. Let's see. Kind of the hot dogs, it comes at an angle on art. Or they goes the. Oh crap. Goes the other angle, the other way. What was that? Because that's kind of up whenever on my computer. That looks good. What was that? Gonna go crazy on my screen. Social copy. Hit the thumbs up. Go ahead and delete that. Tower. Just a little bit. PC specs. And we can, specs. High up. Oh, there we go. Perfect. Okay. Got PC specs. now we need donations. I think that's it. Donations. Put that down. And the computer, go ahead and do a money icon PNG. Alright, I think that's all of them for this. Let's go ahead and take a look what we got here. These are the banners. Don't really need that anymore. Let's go ahead and put that. We can put that as a generic background. We've got our banners, our offline screen, we got the overlay. Very simple stuff. Again, I'm not an expert at overlays or anything like that, but this is just kind of something to start you off with. The PSD link will be in the description, so go ahead and download that Mediafire, mess around with it. Yeah, thanks for watching.